Trust me, you really want to try this out. Whether it's a game or a storytelling experience or a virtual training, using haptic vibration can massively enhance the quality of your project. It adds a new level of immersion into it. And today I want to show you a set of tools that Meta provides us to easily and quickly integrate haptics into your application. And the coolest thing is, this is not just for the Quest, this works cross-platform. So whether you are building on Quest, of course, but also on PCVR, PSVR, Pico, it works for all of them, and we will also show you how to get started. So let's check it out. If you don't know me, my name is Dinesh. I have been working in the XR industry for almost a decade now. We work with companies like Meta and our enterprise partners, really bringing the community together. So our flagship event, XRCC, is where we have our hackathons to really push the boundaries of what this technology is capable of. So thanks Meta for sponsoring this video and for all of your support, and let's get started. So the software I want to talk about is called Haptic Studio, and later on in the game engines we will use Haptics SDK. But Haptic Studio is basically two parts. So we have the desktop application, so here Mac or Windows, and you can just download it. I will link it in the description, no worries. And once you have it installed on your desktop, boom, there we go, you have the Haptic Studio application. So on the Quest you can download the companion app, and then basically, very cool, you just connect to your desktop and it works wireless, which is pretty awesome. So you just go and connect and it should show up green. There we go. And then basically you can just get started right away. So for example, I can play some sounds, of course, from the Quest already. And the cool thing what I want to show you now is really that it's very easy to just import sounds, create haptics based off those sounds, and then you can design them. So you can fine tune the haptics, basically you can audition it really easily. So this is something that is in general pretty complicated, but here it's super smooth because you can do your changes and you can feel them right away. Then you can export them and get them ready for integration into your application inside of Unity or Unreal Engine. So let's create a new project, and we have a couple of sample sounds already that we will share with you. Because this is going to be a series, we will have a couple of tutorials in the next videos also talking about how to integrate them with the interaction SDK, and also we will build a mini game using all of that so you can have a really cool experience yourself using haptics. So now let's see what we can do with these sounds imported. So first of all, if you import a folder that keeps the same structure as well, so that is also really handy. Now we have let's go to the game counter, for example, and we can first of all zoom in, zoom out to kind of get a better image of this sound. And since it's connected to the Quest, one thing that is really cool is you can just press B, and I think you can feel something, or you can at least hear something. So again, that's the whole point of this video. Really try it out. You just saw how simple it is to set everything up, and then you really want to feel the vibration. It just feels exactly like the sound. And it's, again, VR is already impossible to describe to somebody without trying it out. This is something I always say, you have to try out and experience VR. And again, with haptics it's even more important to try it out, because how the hell do you then explain it?
The sound's waveform is visually displayed in the background and can be toggled using the audio wave button above. The blue and red envelope, however, represent the content of the haptic effects, not the sound. So what we see is the haptic data generated based on the sound that was imported.
Now there are a couple of things that we can do in the design process, so we can change some of these values over here. And there are these settings that we have. So first of all, we have the amplitude, and the amplitude controls how strong or weak a vibration feels over time. Think of it kind of like adjusting the volume of the haptics. So if we take this gain, for example, and we increase it, boom, we see it just goes up. So it makes the vibration stronger. And you see here at some point it starts clipping. So it's kind of like it's losing its texture, because you just hear like a brrr, and you can't really feel these details anymore. So in general, I would recommend not to go too high here, because again, then you don't have any of this fine tuning anymore. Of course, you can go as low as this, and I can feel it, of course. So now the vibration is much weaker, and now it's very strong. Yes. And again, here we lose the detail. And speaking of detail, this is the next part, resolution. So here, and let me just show it zoomed in one of those parts. You can basically fine tune in how much detail you want to have in those spikes, basically. So if you go really high in the resolution, you have like a lot of points And if you go lower in resolution, you have very little points, and you can also change these, and I will show this later on. Let's now talk about emphasis. So an emphasis point is a quick sharp vibration that feels like a click, and it's useful for haptic feedback, kind of where you have UI clicks or like buttons when you have like some very small but distinct vibration feedback. So you see it here in the green line basically, and if you increase the sensitivity, that just means that more of those points get detected. So you just see a lot of them, and if I now click it, yeah, I can actually feel it even. You have more of these stronger points. It feels more like, if that makes sense. It's difficult to explain, but that's why you really want to try it out. And if you decrease the sensitivity, you get or now you get none, but here you get only like a few points, and that is definitely something you also want to try out. And the envelope reduction makes the emphasis stand out more basically. And the last point here is the frequency. So the frequency controls how fast or slow a vibration feels over time. Think of it like adjusting a pitch of a sound. And we can also switch to frequency right away.
Why frequency is important? Frequency modulation slash changes over time plays a very important role in the character and texture of haptic effects.
And then here with the audio filter, you can define how, what kind of audio you want to extract. So from what ranges over here. So for example, here we have like 190 to 680. And here with the haptic output, you can again kind of define the range that you want to show. So these would be the high ones and these the low ones. I will not try this out because I know you will not be able to feel it by watching the video. So you will be able to feel it when you try it out yourself. A couple of other things that you can also do while designing. And again, we just jump between designing and audition because you design it, so you can change your haptics over here. So the cool thing is also, actually, let me just show it with one of the simpler ones. So this is pretty simple. Here you have two distinct sounds. So let's actually do some design tuning in this one here. So you hear it and maybe you feel it. And now what we can do is there are multiple ways how we can change these things. So first of all, let's change these points individually because I want to kind of like showcase how much fine tuning we can do. So we can take first of all, we can select multiple of those. We can select them individually. We can move them around. We can do something like this, for example. We can also remove individual points and we can add individual ones. So now this one, for example, has kind of the spike instead of the other ones, and we can design them in any way we want to. And now here, for example, just to kind of like get the feeling, let's have a strong one in the beginning and a weak one in the end. That's how I now designed this sound or this haptic. And now if I press, yes, I feel it actually. It helps if you close your eyes. So it starts strong and then it kind of goes weak, which kind of makes sense, of course. And now if we change it, let me actually, and again, that is just like the surface level of, the surface level of what you can do in this tool. There's a lot more that you can do. And there are some tutorials in the app as well. And there is also some documentation and some other guides with a lot more detail and fine tuning and nuance that I will link in the description. So of course, if you're interested in that, then definitely check it out. I will leave it there and then you can try it out for yourself. But here, I just want to give a basic overview. And let's see, let me actually just remove this part. Let me remove some of those as well. And now we kind of like start weak and it goes strong. And now we can test it again. Yes, you can definitely feel the difference. And I just want to see what happens if I go crazy. And if you go like this, you really just feel brrr. That makes sense. Now, assuming you are finished with your fine tuning and you're happy in the way that you have it, you can also now go to share the project, which is pretty cool. So this one creates a zip file, which includes all the haptics and the sounds. So whoever you're collaborating with, that person has everything accessible immediately, which is pretty cool. Like you don't have any random import problems and any of that. But now one thing that you can also do is of course export your project and get it ready for integration. So therefore we would go to file, export all, or select it if you want to have only a few sounds, but let's go with export all. So here we have the .haptic file. This is the file that is used by the Haptics SDK, which is for the Quest devices and PCVR. Then we have .ahap. This is, as you can read, for iOS and iOS integration, mobile devices so far. And then we have the waveform, which is for PSVR, standalone Pico, and also general audio engines if you want that also. And now if we go and hit export, we see where we want to save it, we can view them, and now we have all of our haptics over here, which we can then use for integration inside of the Haptics SDK with your favorite game engine, Unity or Unreal. We now talked about how to import your sounds into Haptic Studio, how you create these haptics based on that, how you can design and audition them. And the last part of the pipeline is the integration into Unity or Unreal Engine using the Haptics SDK. We will talk about the Haptics SDK in our other videos on the Immersive Insiders channel. I will link them below, no worries. But here are a couple of words why this is super interesting as a developer and really essential to kind of like for the whole pipeline to try out as well. So one really cool thing is that the latest version of the Haptics SDK launched with full OpenXR support for Unity and Unreal Engine. So you can use one workflow for publishing on the Quest and then easily also publish for other platforms like HTC or PCVR, Steam, and any platform that supports OpenXR. Next to the cross-platform capabilities, there are some other cool features that I really like about the Haptics SDK, and they really help you to build flexible games or applications and do like real-time changes. Some of these features are things like playback priority, looping, modulation, so you can really fine-tune a lot of things in real time when you don't want to design things beforehand. And also the haptic clip player priority determines the order in which haptic clips are played. So if you have like multiple things at the same time, you don't have like one massive brrr in your controller, you kind of like can define, hey, this is more important than this one, and you don't want to feel everything all the time. So there are some interesting ways how you can set the priorities. You can also set the ranges and the strengths in real time. So if you're like further away from a object, something like this, you can have the haptic vibrations weaker, for example, and do all of those things inside with code capabilities. So whatever your creative limit is, you can basically build it. And the cool thing is, again, we will show you all of these detailed things on the other channel, so I would highly recommend to check it out. And just get started and then see for yourself. Thank you so much for listening, and thanks Meta for the support. If you have any questions, of course, leave them in the comments below, but otherwise I will link all of the videos over here that will be published soon after this video. And definitely give it a shot, because this is a big unfair advantage, because many people don't know this yet, and you can really have some very easy and simple way to actually enhance a new level of immersion that most people really don't think about. So check it out here and see you soon.